I try never to force my writing because it usually sounds forced and it's usually garbage. But I allow myself the opportunity to write every day.
We did a lot of writing on the road, actually. When you're delivering parcels, we, you know, we pull over, phone our answering machines, and do the la 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 kind of thing into our answering machine, and race home to, you know, so we wouldn't forget this thing. You know, race home, pick up a guitar, and take it from there.
You can have great vocals and great guitar work, but if those songs really aren't there, you're just only going to go so far. And with Alias, we are so enthused, again, because those songs are there.
After working on this record for so long,
I wanted something that had a lot of chunk to it. And having Freddy, as you know, I mean, Freddy's, he's, I mean, this guy's got a turbo voice. He can hit notes, you know, beyond belief. So we wanted to really feature those things, you know, drums, guitar, and his voice. Definitely have to have videos. I mean, it's a competitive business, and if you don't have a video, people don't get to see what the band looks like. It's good that we started off this way rather than having to go out there and do the big acting part, because you know, I'm not quite sure how great actors we are, but we just went out there and played, and you know, it was basically based on a live performance from our end.
You can cut your own throat if your video doesn't live up to the expectations of a radio audience. I just wish that there was a live MTV, an LMTV, where you saw just bands performing live, whatever song it is that they have out as a single.
We'll open up for one of the great groups who's going to be out during the summertime. And I think what will occur is that the reaction to Alias in those arenas will be so strong that it'll set up the foundation for them going out on their own headline tour.
A sound that gets those kind of phones in 1989 is going to get a lot of phones in 1990, and I'm banking on it.
And we do believe that when the songs are given their chance, as they will be on radio, and when they're played in record stores, and when people in the press hear the band, that what will occur is that people will fall in love with the songs. They will love the musicianship. They will absolutely fall in love with Freddy, because he's got that charisma.
I think that this band will definitely be making very serious records throughout the decade of the 90s and hopefully right into the next century.
It's going to be such a buzz.
I would play every day. I would tour. I would, you know, be in concert every single night, because there isn't a better feeling in the world. There isn't a drug or booze or anything that can beat it. The feeling is just incredible.
The whole band is into touring like you wouldn't believe. Everybody wants to play. It doesn't matter where, how long. We'll play 7 days a week. Like, we just want to play.
You want to give something new every night. You want to get out there and make sure that you're excited. You keep yourself on that edge of not knowing quite what's going to happen. So you force yourself to just go out there and mix it up, take a chance, and just kind of not worry about things and let it come out.
In my mind, when I visualize the band, it's huge. It's huge. It sounds huge. Huge stage, huge response.
The feeling in the band is really unified, and we're really mates, and we're ready to take on the world.
It's going to be interesting, because we plan to do some hard tunes and some sheriff tunes, and obviously all the Alias stuff.
Oh yeah! Woo! The sum of all five of us is greater than anyone individually, and it's already evident.
I can't wait to see what this group is going to be like.
Yeah, it's the rock and roll thing to do.
Sure.